Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another card making video. Today I'm showcasing the new Spellbinders card kit and I will be creating 10 cards. But first let's do the unboxing and see what's included. When I am featuring the Spellbinders card kits, I always say that they are a great value for money, and this card kit is no exception. The kit this month is called Love the Moment, and here is the leaflet that you get inside with instructions on how you can make a couple of cards and some ideas. So just like always, you get some basic things like 10 envelopes and 10 cards. These are 4.25 by 5.5, so the standard size, as well as some foam squares and double-sided tape, which are always handy. Now let's take a look at the dies for this month. There are 11 in total. So you get lots of bits and pieces that you can put together to create a car, along with a heart balloon. And there are those little hearts that actually spell the word love, and they fit inside the heart balloon. There are two dies that cut out the words the and moment, so the complete sentiment would write love the moment. I will be using the dies in one of my cards today, so you will see how you can put the card together, which is pretty easy. This is a big pack of glitter leaves. There are different designs inside. There are so many of them inside, and I know that you will be using them throughout the year. I think they are a great addition for your stash, especially if you are creating lots of flower cards. Now let's move on to the stamp set. So you get this lovely frame with the flowers all around, and inside you can fit any of those lovely sentiments. You can stamp and color the flowers on the frame, but I think it would look great if you just emboss it. Now let's take a look at those gems in 3 different colors and 4 sizes. And there is a sticker pack, just like always. Some of them are dimensional. You get lots of sentiments in smaller and bigger fonts. And let's take a look at the paper pad for this month. This is a 6x6 pad. There are 20 different designs, as you can see on the outside, and you get 2 pages for each design, so 40 pages altogether. They are not double-sided, as you can see, and some of them have some lovely foiling, gold foiling, like this one with that lovely marble effect. I love this, is my favorite probably from the whole pad, with the butterflies. I will be using many of these pattern papers today on my cards, as I absolutely love playing with paper. And before we go to the die cuts, let's take a look at the cardstock. You get 8 pieces of cardstock this month. Of course, it matches perfectly the colors of the pattern papers. And 2 of them are really shiny. Hopefully you can see the gold and the silver there. And now let's go to my favorite part of these kits, which are the die cuts. I absolutely love playing with paper and putting cards together that they are really easy to recreate, and this kit gives me that opportunity to play with pattern paper and lovely focal points. So I'm going to take everything out. You see, you get hundreds of them here. There are many different designs as well as sentiments. I'm going to spread them all over my desk so you can see them. And you get each design twice. So here they are all together. I like to keep an order. For example, here I have all the flowers and the leaves. Here are all the sentiments and words. Up at the top I have all the tabs, and so on. This system really helps me to find how to mix and match them. So let's start with the first card. They are all going to be very easy to recreate, and you will be able to make them without having anything extra out of what's included in the box. So I'm using my favorite pattern paper here, and I cut it out to size. The black panel is 4.25 by 5.5, and the pattern paper is 3.75 by 5. So that gives me a lovely black border all around. I'm going to stick this panel on top of the gold cardstock. I'm not measuring anything, I'm just eyeballing, leaving a very thin border all around. This is going to bring everything together, all the little elements that I have on my card. So I have some gold shine here, and I have some gold shine on the sentiment. I'm using foam squares at the back and I'm going to stick that at the top, and this is going to finish my card. Super simple but very beautiful. It is a very busy pattern paper but so gorgeous, so you really don't need to do anything at the top. I just chose this die cut because it is black and it helps it stand out against the background. I'm going to stick this panel on top of the black pattern paper. You can stick these panels on top of a pre-folded standard card that comes in the kit and call it done. If you want to embellish it just a little bit more, you can use one of those golden leaves. I just use my scissors to make them smaller and tuck them behind the tag. These leaves don't cover up many of the butterflies, so you can still see the beautiful pattern paper, and at the same time they add one more touch of gold, so it brings everything together. You can see here some close-up photos on the first card for today. Here is another lovely paper, but it is very busy, so I'm going to show you an idea on how you can use such busy pattern papers. I'm going to cut it down to size. I always like to have a border on my cards, so I use that lilac cardstock as my base. And I'm going to stick that down. The lilac is 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. This is 1/4 of an inch smaller on each side. So I end up having a lovely border. Now at the top, I'm going to stick one of the stickers that come in the kit. And these are three-dimensional. I don't know if you can tell. So this has a lovely sentiment, so at the same time I end up having a focal point on my card that stands out against the busy background, and I have a sentiment as well. I'm going to add a secondary sentiment to complete it and add some extra something on the card. For that I'm using some foam tape at the back. This has a lovely foiling on top. And this is the leftover from the previous card. I'm going to fuzzy cut one of the butterflies, so I'm just going to use my scissors and go all around the black lines. I'm not going to leave any border at all. And then I'm going to use foam squares at the back of this butterfly and stick it on top of my sentiment just to embellish it a little bit more. Here's another pattern paper which I absolutely adore. All those polka dots are gold, and I used my paper trimmer to cut it down to be 3 1/4 by 4 1/2, I believe. And just like I did with the previous card, I'm going to stick on top one of the dimensional stickers that has also gold foiling. And like I did in the previous card, I'm following the exact same design. I embellished it with one of the die-cut butterflies from the kit. I didn't fuzzy cut this one. So I'm going to stick that on my card base, and you can see that since my panel is quite small, it allows for a thick white border all around. And here are some close-up photos. Now, as you can tell, I'm drawn into those pattern papers that have foiling on top of them. I find them really elegant to use, and I'm going to combine this one with the red cardstock. You can see it creates a really elegant combination. On top of them, I'm going to add that lovely flower bouquet. I was just eyeballing if I like it to be smaller, and I just trimmed it down. I am going to use my tape runner at the back, stick it at the bottom of my panel. And I have a thin strip of the gold cardstock here. I am going to stick that where those two papers meet. This is a design element that I like to repeat in my cards again and again. I find this detail really elegant when it comes to thin strips of gold paper. I'm going to use some foam squares at the back of this die cut and stick it on top. Of course, you can center the die cut if you like. I decided to offset it a little bit and add one more die cut on the side. I think it is really pleasing to the eye the way they come together, and I'm going to finish it off with some of the red gems. The little black tag that I used has a foiling on top as well, and it says special event, so I think it would make a great card for birthdays as well as anniversaries. By the way, if you are wondering, I like to create the panels in different colors and then I stick them on top of the white pre-folded cards. so I always have white on the inside of my cards to write anything I want. And here is another gorgeous pattern paper with foiling on top. I absolutely love this marble effect. I'm going to cut it down to size. Again, this is a quarter of an inch smaller on each dimension. And I'm going to stick that on top of my black panel. That's 4.25 by 5.5. I absolutely love a black mat with bold colors. I think it helps them pop even more. Now, I am going to use a thin strip of gold. Again, I used the included cardstock to cut it out. I'm going to stick it at the center. I'm just measuring using the grid at the back of my table. And I'm going to try and make sure that this is completely straight. At the center, I'm going to use one of the tags with foam squares at the back. I absolutely love this one. In foiling, it says Carpe Diem, which is the day. And it has the dictionary definition underneath. I absolutely love this one. And there is another one about traveling, which I'm going to use on the next card. So I'm going to embellish that all around using some of the die-cut flowers and the leaves. For some of them, I'm using foam squares at the back. For others, I'm going to stick them completely flat just to create something interesting looking there. And I finished off the card by adding a few gems, which you can see here in the close-up photos. Now, this pattern paper doesn't have foiling on top, but it is a map, and I absolutely love maps and traveling. So I'm going to cut it to be a thin strip of paper, and that's about 2 inches, which I'm going to place at the bottom of my card base. The focal point for this card is going to be this sticker from the kit. This is a dimensional one, but I don't want to use the banner. So I'm just going to use my scissors and cut it off completely. Don't be afraid to cut off different elements and make them your own so that they can fit better with the design that you are going for. I'm going to trim off a little bit the base, and I'm just measuring and trying to decide how and where this is going to go. And I'm going to combine it with another tag that says travel with a dictionary definition underneath. I'm going to stick them on top, and I think this would make a great masculine card. And since I have some foiling on top of the sentiment, I'm going to add a strip of gold again where those two papers meet. So this way I ground the card somehow so it doesn't look as if it is floating. And in the die-cut set, this comes this geolocation tag, which I'm going to stick with a foam square. And I was trying to decide if I want to stick this arrow that says destination, but it didn't fit with the design, so I'm going to leave it aside for now. And this is the finished card. Here is a gorgeous pattern paper. You can fuzzy cut it with your scissors and use it as a border. Pop it even with some foam squares at the back. However, I'm going to show you another idea. So I cut out a piece from this pattern paper, and on top I'm going to stick this die cut that says love. This will go at the very top, kind of at the edge. And once these two are nicely connected, I'm going to use my scissors and I'm going to cut out any pink pattern paper pieces that you see over the word love. This is really easy to do. You just put your scissors behind the letters, so you don't have to do a perfect job. This way I end up having a lovely border at the top. I'm going to stick that on top of my card base, or you can use foam squares and pop it on top of your card if you like dimension. I will use my scissors to trim off the excess paper, and now you can leave it as it is, or if you want to embellish it a little bit more, you can use some of the pink gems included in the kit and add a few of them here and there. You can call this card done, but I'm going to show you another way on how you can take it a step further and make it look even more special. So I'm going to use those two flowers from the die cuts. I'm going to add some foam tape at the back and stick them on top of those flower arrangements. And this way I end up having some dimension on my card, while everything matches perfectly. Now let's make a card using the dies from the kit. I used a card to cut it out from white cardstock. I'm going to stick on top the black wheels. On top of them, I used a silver cardstock to cut out different bits and pieces to embellish the car. So this goes on top of the wheels, and on top of that silver, I'm going to add those little triangles for the wheels again. In the leaflet that comes with the kit, there are instructions with photos on how you can put this car together. But it's really easy to do, and all I'm doing is just sticking down all those little silver bits and pieces. And of course I have handed a little leaflet on the side just to make sure that I don't make any mistakes. So here are the instructions. For this card as a background, I'm going to use again the polka dot pattern paper. Remember, you get two of each design. So again, this is a quarter of an inch smaller on each dimension. I end up having a border. I have a foam squares at the back of the two balloons and the back of the car. So I'm just trying to decide where everything is going to go. And I have some string here. This is, I need three pieces. This is going to be the string for the balloons, which I'm going to secure at the back with some tape. So now I'm sticking down the balloons, and for one of them I'm going with glue just to create some visual interest there. I'm going to put those together, the strings, as if they are tied at the wheel. And once I decide where I want them to come from, I'm going to stick them down with a piece of tape. And then I can place the car on top. Now to finish it off, I'm going to use one of the sticker sentiments that says "Be happy." And here is the finished card. Now for this card, I have a white panel that's 3.5 by 4.375, which I'm going to stick on top of a 4.25 by 5.5 cardstock. That's a lilac one. At the back of this die cut, I'm going to add some foam tape, just to pop it on top of my card, and this is going to be the focal point. And I picked two identical butterflies from the kit, and I'm going to stick one on top of the other by using foam tape at the back. So this way I am creating a dimensional element with the flaps at the bottom sticking out. I'm going to use some glue and stick that on the other element. I'm going to stick that towards the top of my cardstock, and since I have a clothes hanger, I had this idea to have some string at the top of my card as if the clothes hanger is hanging from there. So at the back of my panel, I'm going to add two little pieces of double-sided tape. I'm going to peel them off. Now I will use the string at the front, just arrange where I want this to be and secure it at the back where that double-sided tape is. I absolutely love the focal point that I created. I find it super cute and adorable. Now I need to stick down a sentiment, and I picked this one that says "Stay unique." It matches perfectly the rest of the colors. And I'm going to finish off my design by sticking down some of the gems. And finally, I'm going to show you an easy design that you can use again and again when you want to stick on top focal points. So I have some adhesive at the bottom of this card base. I'm going to stick the pattern paper on an angle, and then I'm going to use my scissors to cut off the excess. This gives some interest, and you can use it with any pattern paper that you have at home. Now at the top you can stick any focal point that you have. In this case I'm going with this lovely flower arrangement. And as a sentiment, I'm going with a stamp from the stamp set that says "Grateful." I stamped that with my embossing ink, applied on top my white embossing powder, and I'm heat setting it. Now it's time to stick the flowers on top. For that I'm going to use the rest of those foam tapes. and I like to stick that kind of offset. I think it adds more to the design. And I'm going to finish it off by simply sticking some of those gems and spread them out on the white space of the card. And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. I had so much fun playing with this card kit. Do you want to see all the cards together? So here they are, all the 10 cards that I made while playing only with the products that were included in the Spellbinders card kit of the month. Don't forget that you will find links to everything I used down below in the description area. And now let's take a quick look on what's left from the kit. It feels like half of the kit and more is still here, so I still have lots and lots of stickers, used only a few of them. And although I used lots of gems, most of them are still here. I have many, many more die cuts to recreate the same cards that I made or even create more. Most of the glitter leaves are here. Of course, I have the dies and the stamps so that I can use them again and again. Great addition on my stash. Many of the pattern papers are still on the pad, and I have lots of cardstock left over. So after creating all those 10 cards, it feels like more than half of the kit is still here. And that's why I absolutely recommend this card kit. I think you will have lots of fun with it. So I hope you had fun, that you got inspired as I was creating all these cards using products from the Spellbinders card kit. Don't forget to let me know which one of those 10 cards was your favorite. Like this video and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.